About a month and a half ago, we tackled the writ of Kalikasan that halted the construction of a power substation near the NAIA Terminal 3. Well, the Court of Appeals has spoken, at least to the residents of Makati and Pasay City, saying it was unconvinced by the alleged links between high-voltage wires and various diseases.
The Court of Appeals has dismissed a writ of Kalikasan petition filed by Makati and Pasay residents that sought a halt to the installation and operation of high-voltage power lines near their subdivisions. The transmission line will supply more or less 115 kilovolts of power to the NAIA Terminal 3. In their petition, the residents claim the electromagnetic field, or EMF, produced by the power lines and the extreme low frequency, or ELF, generated by the 115 kilovolt high voltage wires could lead to cancer, leukemia in children, Alzheimer's, and a host of other diseases. In its decision, the court stated that petitioners were not able to establish a solid link between EMF and its impact on health and the environment. The court also found inconclusive reports of studies on the adverse effects of EMF and ELF. At best, the court adds, the data gathered are purely statistical in nature. In a guesting on Future Perfect last December, a Meralco representative said their own studies show that the power lines emit even less radiation than fluorescent lights. The appellate court gave way to Meralco's evidence that the magnetic field emitted by the high-voltage wires still fall way below the exposure limit set by the International Commission on Non-Ionizing Radiation Protection and adopted by the Department of Health. The CA said the power firm also met the height and the distance requirements under the Philippine Electrical Code.
Well, thank you for joining us. I'm Tony Velasquez. You can join me again next week when we again examine the present and look ahead to the future perfect of Philippine tech.